Mr. Ravi Verma, the chairman, Mr. Farooq Saab, the vice chairman, and also the chairman of this convention, the outgoing president, Mr. Panse, and the incoming president, Mr. Irshad, Mr. Irfan Razak Saab, who just spoke, and who is also a big name in Bangalore. Members of the outgoing team, members of the incoming team of NAR, and all the dignitaries, those have come from many countries and from the different parts of the country. I don't have much expertise in real estate, but I should apologize that our chief minister, our deputy chief minister, and the housing minister, those who were supposed to be here today, for the reasons all of you know, that there are by-elections going on in Karnataka in 3 parliamentary constituencies, 3 Lok Sabha constituencies, and 2 assembly constituencies. Even in my hometown, which is Ballari, though I stay in Bangalore, even in my hometown, that is Ballari, we have a Lok Sabha by-election. I was there, and the housing minister was there with me. I traveled all the way from Ballari to Bangalore to be a part of this convention, to be with you. Primarily because I thought someone should represent the lawmaking community. And then the other reason is I have lots of friends in this industry. I shifted to Bangalore about 3 years back from Delhi. But before I shifted to Bangalore, I used to be in charge of the Youth Congress of Mumbai and Maharashtra, and then Hyderabad, Assam, Uttar Pradesh, and so on. And in most of these places, I did have lots of friends working in the Youth Congress who were from the real estate community. So that's why I have lots of friends. I thought I should be there, though I don't have much of expertise, but I know a bit as to how this entire business operates and how things take place in this business. I think the network that is being created by NAR, National Association of Realtors, where you have realtors, where you have developers, where you have other people connected with the real estate. I think this is a fantastic idea because this NAR is giving a platform to all the people in the country and also people from abroad to interact among themselves, to come on a platform, to share their experiences and expertise, and to work unitedly and to grow unitedly. I think this would be even more better if NAR coordinates with the government, with the people those are working in the government, or the government itself, because as Mr. Irfan Razak was mentioning, ultimately the policies are framed by the government of the day. I used to be on the debate as a national spokesperson of the Indian National Congress when the real estate regulatory bill was being discussed, now which is now RERA, when it was being discussed. So ultimately the government steps in not only to formulate the policies but also to see the policies are implemented. So there I think it is not only the issues of the real estate community to be taken care, but at the same time I think since we as a government will also have to look after those people, or we should be concerned about those people who are not so privileged. I know most of the people those are present here are realtors, not many developers are here, but I think some developers are also there on the stage and also off the stage also. I think we should also look at as to how we can cater to the underprivileged section of our society also. How we can look at budget housing, low budget housing also. How we can look at affordable housing also. Because as somebody was mentioning now before me, there's so much of rush, so much of influx in the metros because of the migration from 2-tier, 3-tier cities to the bigger cities. There's so much of demand for housing, but what we look at is, we only look at the housing facilities for those people who can afford. But what about those people, those are underprivileged? What about those people who can't afford to have a house? I think this community should also ponder, and in these next 2 days, if you can design as to how you can make use of the spaces that are available in the metros, how you can come out with something that has happened in the Western countries where we can have more people living in less spaces. Maybe we can have taller buildings or something where you can deliberate in the next 2 days, come out with bigger ideas, come out with greater ideas, and then if you give proposal to the government, and I think the Chief Minister and the Deputy Chief Minister, who is in charge of Bangalore City, we can look at it and we can see how not only the real estate community is benefited, not only your interests are protected, but at the same time, that community which is not so privileged can also be taken care. And this has happened in many countries. You take Washington, their people have come up with these kind of ideas. You take Brazil, there is a scheme through which the people that are less privileged have been taken care. You go to Taiwan, where you have more affordable housing with all kind of facilities in that housing schemes for the poorer section. You go to any part of the world where countries have developed, but the underprivileged have been taken care. So, without touching many other subjects, I would just request you all that we all will work together. We as a government in Karnataka, we definitely love to be a part of the ongoing development. We would also like to be a part of your growth story. We'll also like to be a part of your success story, and at the same time, we would also like to protect the interest of the poorer and the underprivileged section. With this note, I would like to wish this convention all the very best. I'd like to wish NAR all the very best, the outgoing team and the incoming team all the very best, and I wish all of you, each one of you, all the very success in your ventures. Thank you so much.